Hey Scorpio, thank you so much for watching this video. Let's see what cards are showing up for you this week. This is the Scorpio Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus signs. This is a weekly tarot reading. So Scorpio, Tower is influencing the complete reading, which is a Scorpio card, so that's a good sign. No boredom. This is definitely not a boring week for you, and if so, then it's still shocking or unexpected. Let's see what's coming up for Scorpio. Okay, you're working on something. Maybe you are negotiating at the moment for houses because I see here that with the Eight of Pentacles and the Four of Wands, that maybe you're busy with finding a new house or negotiating. Maybe you already found a new house, or there's something that you want to go to, maybe to family, maybe abroad, or you feel welcome somewhere. Could be that, for example, if you're dating, that this is a person that you met and they you want to invite them over to your house, for example. The Star Tarot card in reverse is that they might think a little negative about this, but they are almost healed from certain ideas. The Four of Wands is clarified by the Four of Swords and the Ace of Cups. So yeah, this is definitely about inviting someone over to your house. So you're working on something, maybe you are building a house, maybe you are decorating your house, or you are doing something in and around the house to make it ready for someone to enter. So this could be like invitation. For some of you, this might be preparing for a wedding or preparing for marriage. It almost feels like you're preparing everything well, because this may be a special person or a special guest that is coming to your house. So you're preparing everything well. If this is about your business, then in the past I see that you're working on an office. Maybe you rent an office, or maybe you just have a new office. This is a place where what you really, really love. You really love being here. It's almost like a sanctuary or something like that. I hope that's the correct word. It's like a great place. It's a place where you love to be, where you have a lot of maybe a lot of creative things you're doing there. So for example, this is maybe your studio. So you're working on a studio, or you worked on a studio or a place where you felt at home, or where you can do your work well. The Star in reverse, clarified by Three of Swords and Seven of Pentacles in reverse, is that this other person, if there's another person involved or someone you want to invite over to your house, or maybe this is staff that you're hiring that is working at your office, this person, they might think in at first place negative going towards you. They're not so very positive about it in the first place. Maybe they look up to something a little bit, like they don't want to do something in the first place, because they think they can experience hurt, or they're not they associate something with hurt and hurtful conversations, for example. So maybe you have invite someone, but this person experience, or this person expects a little bit like a negative conversation, for example. They don't know what to expect, I guess. It could also be that this person is already in a relationship. So yeah, that's what happened in the past. So you know why this person didn't really feel good coming to your home, or didn't feel really good in a certain location or place. And I think for you this was the best place to be, but it's not for this person. So let's see what happens this week. The Chariot and the Four of Cups are the theme of the reading. So this is about a lot of emotion, emotional overwhelm. It's almost like you feel this is so much emotion that you rather ignore it. So it's too much. It's just too much, maybe, these emotions that you're experiencing. King of Pentacles in reverse, clarified by the Moon and the Eight of Wands. I think that maybe you're someone that really likes to do things for the long term and not so much for the short term. And the situation you are in during this week is almost you're doing almost the opposite from what you're actually like. Maybe this is because of this emotional overwhelm, maybe because you want to ignore your feelings in some way because something is just way too much for you. Yeah, I think you're this person that went, that came over, or that came to your house, or that was invited. I think they have, it could also be that they have found something in your house, or there's something going on. There's something with a location or a house or invitation or in and around the house, like material items, something that caused hurt. For example, if you have been writing a letter to an ex or something like that, or pictures that are somewhere in around the house, but this person experienced a heartbreak when they were at this place. So there's something with a location or something where you was in the past. And what I see in the now is that this probably also affected you. It's almost like you do something all over and over again, or you did that in the past, you did that over and over again. Maybe there are some, how do you say that, people watching that are just inviting new people over and over into their house. Like, I don't know why, but yeah, I don't know what your job is or what you are doing, but there was one person that experienced heartbreak when they came into your house or when they came into the office. This could also be just at your work, for example, that you felt great somewhere, but someone else felt really uncomfortable. I don't know why. Let's just first take a look here, because I think this is why it's not clear. The Moon. So I don't think you have clarity over this situation. Maybe you don't even know what this person felt like when they were there at that location. It's almost like you are very like loving, trying to create a loving space, trying to make everything great, and then this person experienced some kind of heartbreak. But why? Let's find out. Just let's draw another card. Sorry. So Seven of Wands in reverse, Hangman in reverse, and the World. Yeah, this meant really like an ending for them. Yeah, because something to them didn't make any sense. They felt like they really had to sacrifice something when they would stay there. This could also be for long-term relationships, for example, that one partner moves to another location because of work, or for work they have to move somewhere else. And this other person doesn't like it here, and they miss their family and their friends and everything, so they decide to go back again to their to the place they come from. So yeah, they felt really like it was a sacrifice to go somewhere. And with the tower, I think this is something very unexpected for you. So during this week, it's not something that it makes a lot of changes in your life. Yeah, it creates a lot of changes. It's like your world turns upside down because you didn't calculate, you didn't expect this, so you didn't take this with you in your maybe in your planning, if you have a planning. And because of this, maybe you're very emotionally overwhelmed. So something wasn't really practical to do. Maybe you forgot about something. I don't think this is about something you said. It's more something that they found out. I think they found out something and they were waiting for maybe something to happen and it didn't show up. Yeah, something really didn't make sense to them. They really thought like, okay, if it's like that, then I really have to sacrifice something, and that's maybe something they didn't want. So this could be that this other person didn't want to suffer or sacrifice something for this relationship. Because I see for them in the past a lot of suffering and sacrifices that they had to make. So, yeah, during this week, things seem very unfortunate, but in fact, this is in your benefit, because I think that something you're doing or something you're experiencing at the moment is not completely for your highest good. It's not really something that is best for you. So it's not really like what's best for you. There's something better coming on your path. There's something way better coming on your path. So yeah, don't cry too much about this. If someone left you, for example, because something better is coming on your path. Because this is definitely completion from that other person, but there's something better coming up. But at the same time, I do see with the King of Pentacles that you are more probably like a long-term person, wants to stay with someone that you like. Maybe you feel someone wasn't loyal, someone wasn't trustworthy, but still maybe you miss them. And I think this really hurted you, some kind of someone that wasn't loyal to you. Maybe you thought that someone would be more loyal to you. It could also be just in your mind that this person wasn't loyal. Just find out. Let's find out. Okay, maybe you thought someone already was in a relationship. Or maybe you already decided that someone was your husband or wife. You already decided this, like this is what I want, and then suddenly just the ground faded away under your feet, like things were changing completely, or how do you say that? your whole world was changing. And with Sagittarius, I do see your Sagittarius, I also saw here Aquarius. So it could be Sagittarius or Aquarius you're dealing with. Yeah, it could also be Pisces or Scorpio with the Tower and the Moon. If you're dealing with still with the same person, if this is still the same person, they are healed at the moment, they are doing all right, they are making a new start, they feel excited again, or they feel, I think if you want to meet up with them, they are ready to meet up again. I think in the end of the week, this could be the case with the Strength Tarot card. I think this is about being courageous, not being scared for anything, that you can meet when you are doing something. So whatever is coming on your path, whatever is coming on your path, you're not afraid of this and you're just going for it. So I think here with the Strength Tarot card, that and the Nine of Cups, this might be a situation where you and someone else are making up. It could also be a situation where you and the other person, that things are really changing during this week, because I do see a lot of changes here in this tarot reading, the Tower and the Death cards. It's almost like you're both conquering the rules of the universe. It's almost like whatever it takes, you are going for it. You're going for something no matter what it takes. Yeah, it's almost like you, you, even if you know something bad happened, even if you know something happened between you and someone else that you really don't like, you still think, but this is what I want, I don't want anything else, and I'm just going for it. Because this is not because of anything else than but clarity. Because you get more clarity, I think you get more clarity on what you want. You're not so much being bothered anymore about what should be or what should in life or how life should be lived and anything like that. The Magician, clarified by the Emperor and Eight of Wands. Yeah, you're going to manifest this person as your partner. I think the communication goes pretty quickly. Things go pretty quickly. I think this part that happened before, you're probably not even remember it anymore within a very short time, because things are changing that fast that it's almost like nothing happened. So I think that instead of wasting your time and energy on thinking and analyzing, you're taking directed action. So you're taking action that makes you happy straight away. That's the best thing to do. Maybe you're becoming friends with someone. And that's actually how you do it. Because I think you're getting a little bit more aware of it. That maybe you're just not someone for the short term, but for the long term. And if this is someone you really love, and if this is really like a great connection, why should you spill? Why should you... your precious time, why would you waste it on arguments and disagreements? I mean, the King of Pentacles is someone that knows that it is human, people do things like that, but in the end, we just need each other, right? People need each other. So, yeah. So it's just a waste of time to think too much about this. And to, you know, it's a waste of time. And I think you get to that realization that it's just time for action, to be brave, to be courageous. And if you know what you want, you could just go for it. That's it. So that's what I get for Scorpio. And yeah, I think this is a week of becoming very courageous, the knowing, becoming very self-aware, becoming very self-conscious, becoming very aware of what you want, how you want to live your life, how you want to arrange your life, how you will plan your life, how your life should be like, and everything that's coming on the way. Yeah, of course, life cannot be planned completely, but you can have control to a very big amount of your life, and that's also what you're going to do right now. I think you're not so much bothered about what people think, what should be, but I think you're going straight to your goals, not letting yourself being held back by anything or anyone, and just go for it. That's what I get for Scorpio. So thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, and see you next time.